People of Reddit who work in a casino, what's some of the saddest moments you witnessed? Former poker dealer at a casino. An older gentleman started to have a heart attack at the table. I called the floor person for assistance with the call button. Paramedics are rushed in, etc. All within minutes. In this instance, I'm instructed to keep the game rolling by the floor person as he whispered in my ear. Two hands are dealt and played, and a player at the table requested the heart attack guy get moved somewhere else as it is disrupting the game. Another player asked to have his chips picked up and call for the open seat because we have a wait list. I was disgusted. A guy blew his retirement and had to go back to work. He was a retired postmaster and went back as a delivery driver. Edit, I'm starting to feel my job isn't all that boring. I've got another sadder, darker story from my casino employment in here somewhere. There were these two middle-aged Greek or Cypriot ladies who were always on the slot machines. Every day when I started my shift they were there, and they were there when I finished 10 hours later. And still there in the same clothes the next day oftentimes. They were super nice and always polite to the staff. One day they hit the jackpot and win big. I think it was either £15k or £45k. It was a good few years ago now. Everyone was overjoyed for them, except the managers obviously. Well, the managers then gave them free meals at the restaurant and an open bar tab until every single penny of that money was clawed back into the casino. I work in surveillance at a casino. You see a lot of sad and fricked up shoot. Old people dying. Seizures are pretty regular. Fights. Sexual harassment. Had few suicides. People using the bathroom on themselves. Even had to review and export coverage of a girl getting raped for the police. Casinos don't invite the best kind of people. We used to have a woman who would be on the blackjack tables for 5 days/nights straight. Her husband would call and tell her that her kids wanted her home. Her boss actually came to the casino to try and get her to leave. She was missing work. I don't know what happened to her, but she's probably ruined her life. We also had a few regulars commit suicide and a few go to jail. Former valet at a casino. The amount of daily regulars who drove barely functioning vehicles full of trash, roaches, and rats who would actually valet their car and go gamble away any money they had to their name was honestly depressing. The saddest I remember was a 90 plus year old lady who drove a 91 Corolla, and when we got in her car we realized she had no power steering fluid at all, and her steering wheel would barely turn. I have no earthly idea how her frail arms could turn it. We went and bought her some before she left that evening. During my 8-hour shift, a gentleman won $15,000 on a slot machine. Punched out at end of shift and had the next 2 days off. Returned to work after my weekend to find the man still sitting at the same slot machine. He had been there for 2+ days losing $15,000. A previous boss of mine worked at a casino in AK. He said he saw all kinds of terrible things, but the worst was when they had to close the main lobby cause a guy jumped from the 4th floor after losing. It's not the big things, it's the little things. You see someone rocking 3 machines at 9 a.m. on a Tuesday? They have places they ought to be, not in this casino. Thanksgiving, Christmas, hell, even Mother's Day, places slammed. Go home, people. My mom works as a dealer at a casino and has told me multiple stories of grown men wearing adult diapers at the table so they don't have to leave to use the restroom. I worked with a woman who would piss away an entire 2-week paycheck within 15 minutes after getting off work, and then she'd start writing checks and hitting the ATM right after. Her family was ruined eventually, and things got so bad for them financially that her husband killed himself. She got a life insurance settlement or some sort of fund upon his death, and blew it all gambling within a month. Her dad died not long after, and left her inheritance, and she lost all that within 2 months. No idea whatever happened to her, but she was absolutely insane. It's been about 15 years, but I worked in one for about 4 years. The one that stands out was a woman who came from the country to the big city to get Xmas gifts for the whole family, including young kids who still believed in Santa and all of that, but spent all of the Christmas money at the casino before going to the mall. Also, a few years later I went back to visit, and when talking to one of the pit bosses about who was still there and whatnot, she told me one of my old regulars, who was actually nice and likable, a rare trait in that business, had recently committed suicide as a result of gambling too much. We had to evacuate and close down for the rest of the day due to a burst pipe causing no running water. When I walked outside, there was an elderly lady throwing a legit tantrum in the parking lot. She was on the ground kicking and screaming. Her scream sounded like something you'd expect from someone who'd just lost a family member, not someone who had to leave the casino for a few hours. I left, but some of the security who were dealing with her told me later she was too upset to drive home, and they had to call a family member to pick her up. I've seen some shoot. A lot of what others have commented is fairly common, but this was definitely the most messed up. In general, people who come for the first time and are super nice and friendly, they don't care about winning or losing much, just came to have fun. They come back a few more times, then after a few years see regulars that don't smile anymore, they don't laugh, they don't count their wins, just their losses, and sweat every calm point they earn, and act like gambling is their job now, and the focus of their life. I've seen more than one person have this happen to them. The other saddest thing is, when a regular stops coming in, and their spouse comes out, and tells us they passed, we're almost family with some of our regulars and it hurts to get that news. Grandmother, mother, and daughter heading to the casino by car from 2 hours away. Mother had a postcard to get a free cast iron pan for showing up. Daughter is more than 8 months pregnant. 1 hour away from the casino, daughter starts to have labor pains. Mother won't stop and take her to the hospital. She's gotta have that $10 pan. They arrive at the casino an hour before the promotion was going to start. Mother raises all hell trying to get her pan, but the workers for the promo haven't arrived yet. Daughter ends up having to be transported by ambulance to the hospital, all over a $10 pan. I did casino security for 3 years, before I became a police officer. Had a codem medical early one morning, around 4 or 5 a.m. Old guy in his 80s passed out, and fell out of his chair, wife sitting next to him. I was the first to get to him, did a quick assessment, and found he didn't have a pulse, immediately started CPR. The old lady looked over, and said, "Oh, he does this all the time, don't worry about him." Between chest compressions, I told her he wasn't breathing and she just kept playing her slot machine. She didn't miss a spin, even when the paramedics took him away. I saw her again the next night, and asked how he was doing. With the straightest face ever, she said, "Oh, he never woke up. I'm sure he's in a freezer by now." And went right back to the same machine she was playing the night before. Worked in a casino for about 7 years, and the one that has always stuck with me was when a kid 18 over 19 came with his friends and lost $100 playing blackjack. Then he was sitting there, looking dejected and watching his friends win. He left and came back with another $100. I could tell from the way he was acting he probably didn't have the original $100 to lose, so he definitely couldn't afford to lose another $100. So I asked if he was sure he wanted to play. He nodded his head and solemnly said yes. Unfortunately, he lost that money too. I worked at a casino as a dealer through college. A lot of incidents were pretty sad, especially with regulars that you liked. One regular would tell me about his middle school age kids, and then I would realize the next week or so later that he was missing their school play/recitals etc. because he was at the tables. I remember working an overpass one Christmas Eve, and begging him to go home when 6/7 a.m. rolled around, because his kids would be up and opening presents. Other times just people screaming at you for stealing their mortgage payments from them that month, then seeing them back again the next day. I worked a small casino for a couple of years, and have seen many. The sadness ultimately made me quit. Can't tell you how many times I've seen people gamble their entire paycheck and either cry and leave in shame, or get mad and try to fight me or staff. A woman approximately mid-30s dancing her ass off on the dance floor of the nightclub, and suddenly dropped dead. I watched her die. All the time a VIP booth was packed, drinks flowing. Everybody picking on the guy that passed out. End of night comes, and they tell us he is going to need a wheelchair, not uncommon. Guy was dead a good hour. The deaths always bug me. Casinos get a treatment similar to airports. The unspoken rule is to treat them as if alive until they get off the premises, even if they are an hour dead. The goal is to get them out as quickly as possible without freaking out the patrons. New Year's was always stressful. It was never a question if someone would die that night. It was a question of how many. A good year would be one. One year we had four. Not a casino employee. My story comes from my time in the military. Slot machines are everywhere in Germany. The small post I was on had a few slot machines in a back room of the bowling alley. One of our NCOs would go every payday and blow his entire paycheck over lunch. We would know if he won or not by the mood he was in after lunch. When he won, he would tell us about winning $600 after dropping $1,500 into the machine. A bit late since there's been so many comments, but nevertheless I got something. Not a worker, but had an uncle addicted to gambling. Worst thing that happened was he used all of his money, lost his job from it, begged for more money, which led to him going to the casino again to spend it. Then he went homeless, and any money there went to gambling again. A vicious cycle, where he slept on park benches and spent any dime on gambling at the nearest casino. Found out all this one day when he walked by my house with a huge beard, looking like he hadn't showered or eaten in a long time. Good ending. Eventually his mom, my grandmother, took him back in when he begged for a place to stay. I now live with him. He works a full-time job with nice pay and doesn't drink or gamble anymore. Not the best at managing his money at times, but it's safe to say he's far from where he started. A couple that used to come gamble at a casino I worked at killed themselves after losing too much money. Same casino had a patron whose son came in to tell her to stop and that she couldn't keep gambling the family's money away. She would easily lose over $10,000 on a lot of days she went in. You get pretty desensitized to the plight of the gambler at your table, but the double suicide and the yelling son stuck with me. Not a casino worker, but I know of a guy who sold his car to a loan shark slash pimp after losing $80,000 in 2 days. He even went to the DMV and transferred the title to a prostitute. Then when he got out of his fog, he used his spare key and found the car. He took it. He was pulled over for driving a stolen vehicle. Not sure how his court case went. Had a player in High Limits hoss wife came in telling him that they needed to go to the hospital. Apparently their son had a stroke. He was still there by the end of my shift. Not a casino, but volunteered at a local fireman's carnival bingo night. 20-something lady was playing quarter per game bingo with roll after roll of silver quarters. I tried explaining to her that they were worth more than a quarter and she didn't care and kept playing with a look of desperate yawn in her eyes. Never won a game that night. In my mind, she was blowing through a coin collection that her parent or grandparent had carefully put together. Parents used to own a small casino, 15 initiables, $100 limits. I worked weekends in the cage. Employees were allowed to gamble once off shift, and I watched one guy, after getting off of work around 7 p.m, proceed to lose his house payment, car payment, child support, maximum out his credit cards, everything by the time we closed at 6 a.m. I wasn't a huge gambler before that, but seeing that first thing scared me off of taking any chances in a casino beyond casual playing. Not a casino, but the most horrible thing I remember hearing about a girl in the army, stationed in Gab. She had a newish baby, and would buckle baby in the car seat and drive across the bridge to SC to gamble. It gets hot as hell in Gap, and this woman one day went to the casino, parked her car on the far side of the parking lot, just past or behind a dumpster. Other patrons remember her getting up occasionally and looking out the door, but being there pretty much the whole entire day. That evening when she drove back on base, she looked in the back seat and noticed that the baby was clearly in distress. Baby had in fact been dead for some hours, was in very bad shape, eyes bulging, weird bubbles coming out of its mouth. Just damn awful. She left her infant in the car seat to bake to death in the sun while she gambled her military pay away. Dealt poker in a casino for 3 years. One of my fellow dealers was arrested on the gaming floor during our shift for stealing rake. I had told him a week or so earlier to be less obvious about it. We had clear tip boxes. He had custody of his 4 kids. Emphasis on had. Not a casino, but a charity poker room at a bowling alley, where I was a dealer. Guy was pretty drunk and just so bad at poker. Kept losing the maximum buy in $300, and would go straight to the ATM and rebuy. With every rebuy, the desperation became greater and greater. I just wanted to tell him to pack it up, before he lost more, but that would have probably cost me my job. Eventually I think he must have emptied his bank account. I had never seen someone lose so much money in one night.